The main opposition UNP today strongly condemned attempts of several government MPs to assault UNP MP Jayalath Jayawardena over his alleged connection with the pro-LTTE protest against President Mahinda Rajapaksa's arrival in the UK.
When we had to be critical of the government, we have done so. If necessary in parliament, if necessary outside parliament, and if necessary even abroad. But I would like to say this. If we have organized anything abroad, we will say so openly and we will be associated with it. We had no connection with the agitations which took place in London during the president's visit. About 4 or 5 weeks back, Dr. Jayalath Jayawardena and Akhila Karyavasa were involved in the agitation in Italy for the release of General Fonseka. But we have had no connection with the agitations that are going on in London.
At a media briefing, UNP MP Jayalath Jayawardena urged the government to start an investigation as to how the protesters came to know the arrival date of President Mahinda Rajapaksa.
Me janadhipathumage guangamang pilibanda rahas toraturu atishayam rahas toraturu me 29 wenida ithuma ingalantere menata London nuwara sancharaya karunoy kiyala kawuru elikalaada kiyeneka barapatala prashnaya apita danaganna puluwan kamak naha api vipakshaya mantriwuru ehemanam London nuwara 29 wenida Mahinda Rajapaksa janadhipathi waraya sancharaya karunoy kiyana e toraturu laba dunne kawuda me udghoshikayinte me toraturu kawuda kiyana පිළිමදව වහාම පරීක්ෂණය පවත්වන්නට ඕන. ඒකයි සිදුවේ. අපිට ඇඟිලිදි කරන්නේ නෙමෙයි. දිනේෂ් ගුණවර්ධන මහත්තයා. පැහැදිලිවම පාර්ලිමේන්තු වරප්‍රසාද පාවිච්චි කරමින් මොකද්ද කිව්වේ? පාර්ලිමේන්තු තුල. ජයලත් ජයවර්ධන ජනාධිපතිවරයා 29 වෙනිදා ලන්ඩන් නුවර හීත්‍රෝ ගුවන්තොටුපළ පැමිණෙන අවස්ථාවේ ද්‍රවිඩ උද්ඝෝෂකයන් සමග ඒ ස්ථානයේ සිටිය බවට සිටිය බවයි ප්‍රකාශ කළේ. මම 29 හිටියේ මිලානෝ නු මන් දන්නේ මට මේ ස්ථාන දෙකක එකවර ඉන්න පුළුවන් දේවබලයක් මට තියෙනවාද කියලා.
සමහර එක්සත් ජාතික පක්ෂයේ සමහර මන්ත්‍රීවරු ජයලත් ජයවර්ධනලා වගේ අය කුටි ත්‍රස්තවාදීන් එක්ක තවම හොර දීගවල යෙදෙමින් මේ රටේ ප්‍රතිරූපය කෙලසන්න අන්තර්ජාතිකව තවම විශාල ව්‍යාපාර දියත් කරගෙන යනවා.
Sri Lankan government ally, the National Freedom Front, called the UK a failed state after the prestigious Oxford Union cancelled a proposed address by President Mahinda Rajapaksa, citing security reasons.
Mahabritannia ita manavin pennanawa oun Mahabritannia puluwan kamak ne wenath rataka rajanayakek tamange ratata awama e aapu katayutta saarthakawa itu kara denima sadaha awashya vatavaranaya sakas karanna Mahabritannia rajayata beri bawa අද මනාලෙස ඔප්පුලා තියෙනවා. ඒ කියන්නේ මහ බ්‍රිතාන්‍යයේ පාලකයන්ට බෑ ආණ්ඩුවට බෑ තමන්ගේ රටට පැමිණෙන කිසියම් රාජනායකයෙකුගේ සැලසුම් කරපු කටයුතු ඉටු කිරීම සඳහා අවශ්‍ය වාතාවරණය සකස් කරන්න ඒ මහ බ්‍රිතාන්‍ය ආණ්ඩුවට බැරි බව මේකෙන් පෙනියනවා. ඒ අනුව අපට කියන්න තියෙන්නේ මහ බ්‍රිතාන්‍ය දැන් අසාර්ථක රාජ්‍යයක් එහෙම නැත්නම් ෆේල් ස්ටේට් එකක් බවට පත් වෙමින් තිබෙනවාද කියලා. ඔවුන් අපට කිව්වා බටහිර රටවල් අපට කිව්වා අපි අසාර්ථක රාජ්‍යයක් කියලා. හැබැයි ඔවුන් කියපු අසාර්ථක රාජ්‍යයට පැමිණිච්ච කිසිම රාජතාන්ත්‍රිකයෙකුට කිසිම වෙලාවකවත් ඒ තමන් සූදානම් කරගත්තු කටයුතු නොකර යන්න ඉඩ දුන්නේ නැහැ.
The Oxford Union, releasing a statement, said that they deeply regretted the cancellation of President Mahinda Rajapaksa's speech and said that the sheer scale of expected protests would not allow the speech to go ahead reasonably and safely. President Mahinda Rajapaksa's visit to the UK was surrounded with wide-scale protests by LTTE sympathetic Tamil groups who had also attempted to obtain a war crimes arrest warrant against him. Sri Lanka's official government news portal slammed the Oxford Union for giving in to terror. It said the remnants of the Tamil Tigers had struck the home of free speech. The statement said the Oxford Union was incapable of identifying the source of the security threats and upholding freedom of speech. President Mahinda Rajapaksa has said that he regrets the cancellation but would continue to seek venues in the UK and elsewhere where he could talk about his future vision for Sri Lanka. Meanwhile, the British High Commission said in a statement via email that the UK government had no involvement in the planning of the Oxford Union event or the decision to cancel it. The statement said that the event was a private one organized by the Oxford Union and the Sri Lankan High Commission in London, and public order and security considerations were a matter for the Oxford Union and the police. Liam Fox, Secretary of State for Defence of the United Kingdom, who called on President Mahinda Rajapaksa in London yesterday, discussed aspects of the wider sharing of power in Sri Lanka and development assistance from the UK, the government said in a statement. Responding to Liam Fox's interest in the constitutional process for power sharing, the President had said that discussions were already underway with Tamil political parties that agreed to work within a united Sri Lanka. Discussions were held in the backdrop of pro-LTTE protests against President Rajapaksa's visit to the UK. President Rajapaksa also met British and EU parliamentarians in London yesterday. The annual Sri Lankan Junior Open Golf Championships 2010 will be held from 15 to the 17th at the Royal Colombo Golf Club, organizers said.
This particular junior golf tournament that comes about every December is the tournament where youngsters show their early promise. It is at this tournament that they gain their first early recognition, and from then onwards, they continue to improve their game and reach greater heights. As we have seen, like the young man Mithun Pereira, who's seated here, who has really reached a very high standard, not only in Sri Lankan, Asian golf, but also in world golf, I would say, considering his performance at the Australian Open last year. So this is where it all starts, and therefore these youngsters need a lot of encouragement.
The US Ambassador to Sri Lanka, Patricia Butenis, has said that President Mahinda Rajapaksa and his brothers and former Army Commander Sarath Fonseka were responsible for war crimes, according to a leaked US cable published on whistleblowing website WikiLeaks. Butenis has told Washington in a cable classified as secret on 15 January 2010 that there were no examples known of a regime undertaking wholesale investigations of its own troops or senior officials of war crimes while that regime or government remained in power. The cable goes on to say that the situation is complicated in Sri Lanka because the responsibility for many of the alleged crimes rests with President Mahinda Rajapaksa, his brothers, military leadership and the opposition candidate Sarath Fonseka. The communique has said that accountability for crimes allegedly committed during the war with the LTTE was not an urgent high-profile issue for Tamils in Sri Lanka, who were keener on addressing immediate concerns like the displacement, resettlement and improving economic conditions in the former war zone. However, according to the leaked cable, Ambassador Butenis has told Washington that Tamil politicians had wanted to keep the war crime allegations alive with the hope of some future action by the international community. Sri Lanka's Ministry of External Affairs said Wednesday that it does not wish to comment publicly on privileged communication of a foreign government. However, the ministry said that it will take up any issue through diplomatic channels in the event any contents reveals material related to Sri Lankan interest. On Monday, the United States deeply regretted and condemned the releasing of classified documents downloaded from its Defense Department computers and uploaded on WikiLeaks, U.S. Ambassador to Sri Lanka Patricia Butenis said in a statement. It said the United States has worked hard to assist the government and the people of Sri Lanka to strengthen security and further economic development and to foster political reconciliation. The Met Department says yet another atmospheric disturbance will affect the weather over the island, causing rain, especially over northern and eastern parts. There will be occasional showers or thundershowers in the northern, north central, eastern and Uwa provinces. Thundershowers will develop over most parts of the island during the afternoon and night. There may be temporary localized fairly strong winds during thundershowers. The public is requested to take precautions to minimize damages caused by lightning.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook.